anti-fertility drugs. Anti-fertility drugs. So before going to explain which or what are anti-fertility drugs and which chemical substances are used as anti-fertility drugs, we have to learn that after the discovery of antibiotics, the life span of the people increases almost double. Due to these consequences, the population also increases, which in terms creates social problems. What are the social things we can face due to increase in population? First one, environmental issues. Second one, food problem. A third one, employment problem. To overcome all these problems, we have to use a type of chemical substances or drugs. They are called as anti-fertility drugs. What is the purpose of this? Due to or while we are going to use this type of drugs, they are going to stop ovulation process in human beings, especially women. Okay, ovulation process. Similarly, here, which type of drug chemical substances are used as drugs are derivatives of synthetic derivatives of progesterone and estradiol. Progesterone and estradiol are used as anti-fertility drugs. So upon, especially while we are going to use progesterone derivatives as drugs, so they are going to stop ovulation process in women. Similarly, estradiol derivatives are also useful to prevent the ovulation process or further processes which may happen during fertilization. So let us learn the progesterone derivative which is used as anti-fertility drugs are norethindrone. Norethindrone. Similarly, the estradiol derivative which is used as ethinyl estrone or estradiol. Ethinyl estradiol is the chemical substance used by us. So these two are used as anti-fertility drugs to stop the, to decrease or to control the over or excess of population. So this is about drugs or medicines. Remember, from the topic of chemistry in everyday life, three important chemical substances and their applications as per our syllabus. The first one is drugs or medicines. So after completion of what is drug, classification of drugs and how they are going to select targets and various types of drugs based on pharmacological activity. So let us learn about chemicals in food. The second topic and more widely used chemical substances are in food. So let us write chemicals in food. Actually, what is the purpose of use of chemicals to our food? Only the reason is to improve shelf time or expiry time and also to improve the flavors and also to add nutrition characters. So for all these aspects, we have to use chemicals towards our food. And let us learn what is the purpose of use of chemicals or what type of chemicals we can use on our food are, first one, flavors. Flavors and sweeteners. These are a type of chemicals we have to add to the food. Similarly, fat emulsifiers. fat emulsifiers. Next, floor improvers. Floor improvers. Similarly, color substances. Color, coloring substances. Similarly, preservatives. Preservatives. And next one, nutritional supplements. Nutritional supplements. So these are various types of category of chemicals that we can add them to food to improve shelf time, to improve nutritional values, and to improve flavor of that food. So come to this. During this topic, we are going to express the use of only one type of or two types of chemical substances. They are sweeteners, artificial sweeteners, and food preservatives. So let us learn. First one is artificial sweeteners. Remember, the natural sweet is a natural sweet chemical substance or naturally available carbohydrate which can provide sweet character is sucrose, which is called as cane sugar. Actually, upon usage of cane sugar can increase calories in human being. So to overcome this problem, the alternative methods are derived by the scientist. In view of this, the artificial sweeteners are artificial chemical substances which can produce sweet character also derived by the scientists. So examples for those artificial sweeteners are saccharin, aspartame, sucralose, and allitame. So what are these? All these are artificial sweeteners. Here, saccharin is also called as ortho-sulfo-benzimide derivative. So the earlierly discovered artificial sweetener is ortho-sulfo-benzimide, and it is also called as saccharin. This saccharin nearly having 550 times more sweet character than sugar or cane sugar. Similarly, aspartame. This aspartame will have nearly 100 times more sweet than our sucrose. Similarly, sucralose nearly 300 times more sweet than sucralose, whereas allitame nearly 2000 times more sweet. It can provide 2000 times more sweetest character than natural sugar. So these are various types of artificial sweeteners available. Come to this. Upon usage of saccharin is a very inert and stable chemical substance. Upon usage of saccharin or ortho-sulfo-benzimide derivative, here it will be converted into hippuric acid during its metabolic process, which will be excreted through urine. Similarly, aspartame, here it is a derivative of aspartic acid with methyl ester of phenylalanine. Here it will provide 100 times more sweet character than natural sugar. Whereas the sucralose is a dichloro derivative of sucrose, and it can provide 300 to 500 times more sweet character than natural sugar. Whereas allitame, it is also a dipeptide, or it is a dipeptide or tripeptide of three or more different amino acids. Here it provides 2000 times more sweet character than natural sugar, but the use of alliterative is not preferential because unstoppable sweet character of alliterative. So this is about here. Let us have the structure of saccharin. The most widely used artificial sugar by human beings is this. It is the structure of saccharin, whereas the structure of aspartame will be consist of C double bond O, CH2, CH, NH2, C double bond O, NH, CH, C double bond O, ME, CH2, and there is benzene ring, or also called as phenyl ring. So like this. Similarly, the two carbons are substituted with chlorine in natural sugar, then it is called as sucralose. So this is about artificial sweeteners. So these artificial, some of these artificial sweeteners like saccharin is better to use and use as chemical in food. And second one, second type of chemicals which may be used in our food are food preservatives. Here the food preservatives are a type of chemicals which can stop the growth of microorganisms onto the food. By this mechanism, they improve shelf lifetime of food. Here, let us learn about the important two types of chemical substances, or two or more types of chemical substances which are used as food preservatives are common salt, that is table salt, sucrose, some type of edible oils, and also the most importantly, sodium benzoate. Here the most widely used food preservative is sodium benzoate. So upon use of sodium benzoate, it can stop the spoiling of food. Sometimes salts of sorbic acid and propionic acid are also used as food preservatives. Propionic acids. Here, during the addition of sodium benzoate with citric acid to the cheese, it improves the shelf lifetime of cheese from months to years. So this is about food preservatives. Similarly, one more type of chemical substances which may be used by us or added by us to our food, antioxidants. We can call them as antioxidants. Here these antioxidants are highly helps to preserve oxygen quantity onto our food. So here two types of chemical substances are there. One is BHT and BHA, butadiene hydroxytoluene and butadiene hydroxyanisole. So these two are the chemical substances used by us as antioxidants to enrich or to keep the oxygen quantity. Why? Because these two are more reactive towards the food than oxygen. So by this mechanism, they can hold the oxygen quantity. Hence, they are called as antioxidants. So these antioxidants can improve metabolic processes of human beings. So this is about chemicals in food.